Welcome to this class. It's a biology practical lesson. We are going to discuss on how to carry out a food test as far as ascorbic acid is concerned. I'm going to give my student here an opportunity to demonstrate on how we normally carry out food tests. And welcome, Kamal. So, take us through the procedures and
here
everything.
We're going to do the procedure for test for vitamin C. First, we're going to add 2 centimeter cube of DCIP.
DCIP is dichlorophenol endophenol.
Now we're going to put it into the test tube, right there. And after that, we're going to grab, add 3 drops of food specimen X.
You add how many drops?
3 drops.
3 drops of
food
specimen
X
into a
test tube.
Yeah, good. Let us see the DCIP first. You hold it so that it can be seen. Then you add as so that we can see what is changing, what is happening. Add. Mm-hmm. Then after adding, what are you supposed to do?
Shake it.
Shake it. Uh-huh.
And now the color has changed to visible color.
Clear.
Yeah,
it became clear.
It became clear. Meaning that the color of this PIP
is present.
The blue color of this PIP was decolorized. Is it okay? Was decolorized. You can see it is a very clear solution. And therefore, what is our conclusion?
The conclusion is the feed of vitamin C is present.
Vitamin C is present. So in that particular food, which he was carrying out food test on vitamin C, it means that the vitamin C is present. Have you understood, student?
Yes.
So when the food specimen is present, the food specimen that you are testing is present, the color should change from
blue to colorless to a clear
solution. Is that okay? So make sure that whenever you are doing a practical, make sure that you remember that, you know that. And if vitamin C is not present, that is ascorbic acid is not present, the blue color of this PIP persists. Are we together?
Yes.
So that will mark the end of today's lesson. Thank you.